Good evening. Today we have Dr. Harish Ahuja, of CEO Indiagosolar. It's our pleasure to pleasure to have him here. Sir, very good evening to you.
Thank you very much for having me here. Thank you very much.
Sir, how do you find this entire event REI?
I think this, I can see a lot of energy around, in fact, and it is, I'm coming from continuously from last 2 days. In fact, I'll be coming tomorrow also. The kind of business activity happening here, the kind of participation we're showing is extraordinary. I'm really loving it.
Sir, can you please tell us something more about Indiagosolar.in?
Indiagosolar is the pioneer solar e-marketplace which is offering solar products, projects and services. This is the only platform which is offering solar solutions like solar rooftop kits from 1 to 10 kilowatts, like solar pumps from 1 to 7.5 HP, solar product like solar platfrom solutions, solar cold storage, solar, now we are coming with solar tree also. So these are the solutions. In fact, the prices ranges from 1 lakh rupees to 25 lakh rupees. We also got the products which are of day-to-day use, like solar mobile charger to solar off-grid solutions, like which can be used for running your day-to-day operation requirement of lighting, fan, etc. So we have a whole range of products, more than 650 products of around 60 different manufacturers, companies are being listed with us and people are trading on the platform online.
Is there any method that you'd like to share, how a company can enlist his products with your portal?
Yeah, we are very meticulous and very systematic in terms of listing our partners. We only choose those players who have got some kind of certification from Government of India, by Ministry of Renewable Energy or SECI or NICE, or they have got some kind of certification from Renewable Energy Development Agencies of states. Because we do believe that when government certify them, when government give them license to do some task, be it of system integration, be it of manufacturing, they pass through a lot of due diligence. So it makes our life easy. And at the same time, there's a lot of credibility this player bring to the market when they come and offer their services and products. But it is a norm now, rather than an exception, that we only allow the MNRE system integrator or channel partners to be our partners.
That's one way to judge their authenticity. Any step that Indiagosolar does from its own for checking their credibility, sir?
Sure. I think being an ex, I will not say veteran of solar industry is very young now. I'm in this industry from last 7 years. I think credible players who are doing really good business in solar and doing really great service to the country are very few. And I know them personally also, because I'm in this industry for 7 years. I'm not a new one. So this is one. Secondly, I think we also put some kind of benchmarks while we evaluate them. In our evaluation criteria, one of the criteria is how many megawatts they have done. There may be people who are the system integrator of MNRE but done less than 2 megawatt or 5 megawatt. So we keep it a practice that they should not have done less than 2 megawatt EPC, or they have not done less than 5 crores of volume on sailing site, you know. And they should carry all the standards. We seek all the, we give certificates of all the standards with us. We verify them, you know, that they hold the standards. Like there was a train sometime back where everybody was claiming that they like to sell the solar pumps. We did not allow anyone to sell solar pump till the time they got certificate from NICE or TUV or other agencies, you know. Unless we see the certificate, we never allowed that. So maybe you're a system integrator, but if you don't hold that particular certificate for that product, you'll not allow. So we do our own due diligence in terms of checking the authenticity of the certificates, your past credibility in terms of performance, and being an old person in the solar industry, many people I know in terms of their performance, because they have some kind of business relation with us in my past era.
Sir, can you tell me how many, on an average day, how many requests you receive for this services?
The traction has now really increased. In fact, now on average we are getting 50 to 80 requests, and if I bifurcate, or I can trifurcate, you know, I say, then most of these requests are for rooftop kits, and these are from pain market. We call it pain market because these are the tier 2, tier 3 rural cities where electricity is a necessity. People like to have electricity, if not for 12 hours, at least for 8 hours or 12 hours. So they are looking for rooftop kits, off-grid rooftop kits. Farmers definitely come to us to know more about solar pumps, but the subsidy element is stop them to buy online. They think that we should arrange subsidy for them. So there are many requests on solar pumps also, with and without subsidy. And third very important request is on utility scale. There are many people who like to go into utility scale site. They've got money also, they've got land site also, but they don't know how to secure PPA, how to secure government clearances. So these people also come for some kind of technical consultancy. We don't keep technical consultancy with us. We have many partners who do that consultancy. We just connect with them. So these are the primary three areas: rooftop kits, solar pump, and consultancy and utility scale. The products being sold online without our intervention.
How do you reach out to the actual customers? What's Indiagosolar's method to reach out to customers so that many more people can enjoy this? This is a nice platform where quality assurance is there. How do you reach to these consumers, actual consumers?
It's a very good question. Because when we were coming with this marketplace, one of the key questions we were asking that, who is my consumer? What kind of consumer is this? And I think we are a marketplace, so we should know to whom we are serving, right? And for that, we adopt a very systematic process from the day one. I think you need to acknowledge that Indian customers like to talk a lot. And when they buy this high-tech, high-value, high-price, low-touch solar product, they like to talk more. So when we started the platform in Feb 2015, the day one, my website was launched. Same day, my customer care number was on. And first day, I got around 4 calls, you know, and that got a lot of insight to us, you know. They were just asking about the features of the product, can it work, how can I buy. So I think this particular consumer, you know, connect with us from the day one, give a lot of insight to us in terms of what customer is looking for, what exactly they can buy online in this stage, why can they postpone later on, what kind of services, what kind of products they will search in the website. We really built upon these insights, and I have got all the recordings with me because initially I used to attend personally those calls. And basis that insight, basis that, we become wise, you know. And we started developing the platform. I think I always thought that rooftop kit would be a right solution for the customer online, because people who are not technically savvy cannot buy module and they can connect on their own. Even electrician needs special training for setting up solar. So we said, why don't we sell solar as a standard solution? And when customers used to call us for module, we used to say, why don't we buy a rooftop kit, which is everything under one box? And they loved it, you know. They said, why not? Because if it works like a fridge, TV, cooler, we'll love it, you know. But can you give a discount, you know, typical Indian mentality. So we built on that knowledge and we brought 50, 60 type of rooftop kits. Then when the farmers started calling us for knowing about subsidy, we said, would you be interested to buy ISO, ISI standard solar roof pump without subsidy? They said, if they're cheaper, we'll be interested. We brought many such pumps online. So that we built upon with this insight. And in fact, and we have got consumer persona very well drawn, you know. Fortunately, we don't do any cold calling. They're all inbound calls. I think because it's one of its own unique platform, we get a lot of inbound calls, and many times it becomes challenge, you know, to attend those queries, because we are a small team right now, you know, and we are scaling up. But I think it's more like a customer feedback, customer survey. We are touch base with the ground level, my own expertise. And over a period, we are getting a lot of, you know, inputs in terms of live chat, emails, the kind of people who like to join us. Now we've got a network of affiliate across India, you know, so we do understand this, you know, psychology of the customer. Accordingly, we have, you know, tried to put the content on the website, and I think the feedback so far is very good. So platform has built from bottom up. So I think we have followed a lot of systems here.
Sir, having said that, primarily, you are an online company. I mean, I can safely say that you are an online company. E-commerce itself is booming in India, but there are still challenges in terms of, I mean, not solar, but there are other e-commerce companies which are facing, I mean, we know the names. They're facing huge challenges. Is any such case that has happened with you, or How do you collect the payment? Is it at advance payment if somebody wants to buy a solar kit, or he can pay on COD, as COD?
So I could see there are three elements in your question. One is e-commerce companies in general passing through a bad phase. Second question you're asking, that how Indiagosolar is different in terms of those challenges. And third is, how do I collect the payment? So let's go one by one. The first question is e-commerce company going through the tough phase? Yes, definitely. I think I will not say companies follow a wrong approach, but they were in the valuation game. And I think you have to understand how they interface with the customer. What exactly customer look forward when they initially interacted with the e-commerce company in 2007-8? I think they made themselves a discounted portal. You know, this kind of, what kind of interface you start with the consumer, build your reputation. I think in our case, we were from the day one very clear that my differentiation will not come from discounts. Our differentiation will come from kind of advisory we offer, because solar is a high-tech product. You know, consumers need a lot of information asymmetry. Even by gaining more knowledge, they become at the better negotiating position to get good discount from their local suppliers, you know. So instead of giving me discount by making my consumer informed, by making my consumer aware around technology, products, warranty, guarantees, how it works, my consumer become very informed. And they were not expecting discount from me, because now by asking this four good questions with their local even suppliers, they could get the discounts because consumer supplier knew. So I think we worked upon how would we keep our interface with the customer. We put a lot of good content, a lot of information around technology, around adoption of technologies, around products, around how it works, what kind of features it has, what kind of services it can offer. We give a lot of empowerment to the consumer. So I think our interface is empowering the customer with knowledge, information, options and auctions. You got multiple options, choose, you know. And there used to be a lot of information asymmetry in terms of comparing a non-standard product with a standard product. You cannot compare a 32-inch TV with 36 Sony or 38, you know, LG. You need to standardize it, you know. You have to give them 32-inch LG, 32-inch Samsung, 32-inch Sony, so that they can compare across the brands. We did it. We tried to give them 1 kilowatt, one category, second brand, third brand, they could compare it. Same thing, 2 kilowatt with 4 hours, 2 kilowatt, 4 hours for 3 different brands, they can compare. If they ask me question now, why is one expensive, I'll say, this is from this national brand, you know. They are in entire India, you know. And they bring this kind of after sale service. So the differentiation was very clear, but they could compare it, you know. Earlier there was no benchmark. So I think we kept our interface of empowering the customer, not discounting the products, you know. Third question which you're asking is about payment gateways, you know. I think it's a transaction-based platform. We don't do list only, we do transactions. If you like something, you can buy. For products, it's very easy, because the products are ranging from 500 rupees to 20,000 rupees. The moment it comes to projects, when I say projects, 1 kilowatt costs 75,000 to 80,000 rupees. We typically come to payment mode of, we offer them EMI options. That, you know, you pay upfront and then based on your credit card, you can get EMI options. So up to 2 kilowatt works many a times. But beyond 2 kilowatt, if the things goes beyond 1.5 lakhs, it brings all the attributes of a project payment. 20% right now with the PO, 80%, 60% at the time dispatch, 20% after 1 week of the commission. So we got back-to-back tie-up with suppliers, they accept it.
Since you are an interfacer, I'd like to understand, you get a lot of calls, you have your call center set up. What is the demand for storage as on date? I'm specifically talking about rooftops right now.
I think you need to understand, when we get the calls from rural market, they only call for upgrade with storage. Now, India is not, I will not say that urban market is asking for Tesla-like storage, but yes, every rooftop kit we are getting query for or we are transacting is with definitely some 4 hours, 5 hours backup. So storage is surely a demand in the rural markets, because they like to see the electricity from 7 to 9 p.m. And after 5 p.m., we suggest them to buy storage. This is for the rural market. In urban market, there's a separate phenomena. People like to run at least one AC. And unfortunately, solar has some issues. If they are not grid connected, even though grid connected, the surge current many a times is too high. We suggest that you should have some in-house storage of 2-3 hours, so the AC surge current can be taken care by your own battery, you know, not by grid. Because many a times islanding happens, you know. Many a times when there's no electricity, you have to depend upon your own battery. So in urban market, there's also a storage requirement, in a rural market, but very different needs. One is basically luxury AC, one is running the lights in the evening. The storage market is definitely the demand.
Still not matured for lithium ion. How soon, as a solar industry specific person, how soon do you see lithium ion coming into picture? Because that will anyhow increase the cost. As on date, lithium ion is very costly, so the entire package cost will change. So is India ready for that?
I think you need to see it from the perspective of the customer. To be very honest with you, there are two separate market working in India, and there's the beauty of Indian market. One is a pain market, like rural tier 3, where electricity is not only electricity. People are not buying product there, people are buying the future of their kids who's in class 12, studying for IIT, you know, or their daughter studying for AIIMS or medical, or wife is preparing the food in the night. For them, any cost is less cost. So they don't mind paying for potassium iron or lithium iron, they don't mind it, you know. For them, it's important that they should get the product so that they can immediately serve the necessity of the home. I don't think people will question too much on pricing in this market. Yes, they're very price conscious market, very price conscious, and they know their budget. And they, I mean, unlike urban cloud, which will negotiate a lot, rural class doesn't negotiate. They know their numbers very well. They know their pocket very well. I think for this market, even pitching lithium ion is wrong. Pitching is wrong, you know, because we know what kind of pocket size they have. So we don't do that, you know. In urban market, solar is a, you know, kind of fashionable necessity. So there's a lot of demonstration effect, you know, now people are going green. Whether it's necessity or there are two kind of people moving to now solar. One is green conscious, which buying it purely for the purpose of showing their commitment to the environment. And there are people who are treating solar as a financial asset. They think putting solar on the rooftop will lead to some kind of income generation day one, and it's a fact. So these are very conscious class in terms of knowing the returns coming from solar. This market may not be happy to pay for lithium ion because the return goes down substantially. So I think I could explain your problem, your question.
Finally, sir, what are your roadmaps to reach more and more customers? I mean, mobile, are we on mobile?
Yes, we are.
It's an app or a mobile compatible?
Responsive web platform, but within a week you will see our web app also, mobile app.
Any plans how to promote this?
Yeah, I think the best part is we are now around 1.5 year old company. We have got our own subscriber, beat our newsletter Suryaveshi, beat our own buyers. Many affiliate touching base with us, many customers we have in our database. So I think this early, you know, innovators or early adopters would be our own 15, 20, 30,000 of people. And we are coming with an innovative mobile app. We are not coming typically of e-commerce mobile app. It's more like informative mobile app, which has additionality of buying something. Because, you know, we don't think that we like to push this mobile app as a platform. We like to push this mobile app or circulate this mobile app as 90% information, 10% products which came from through that information. So I think people definitely adopt it without any pursuer, without any pushing effort.
I mean, that means it's a content driven,
more information driven, less e-commerce driven. Yes.
Fair enough, sir. Thank you so much for your time and such valuable input, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you for giving me the time. Thank you very much.